Hello everyone, what is going on and welcome back to our My Player Career Mode. Thanks for tuning in, hopefully you're all doing fantastic. Today is moving day. After a great 2 years with Borussia Dortmund, winning numerous trophies, we've got a new club. We're going back to the Premier League, back to London, but not in the red this time. We've gone with the blue of Chelsea. And when you see this Chelsea squad, we might be in for just as good a time as we had at Borussia Dortmund. To talk about why Chelsea, we had a few offers on the table. We had one from PSG, which I'll be honest, didn't really interest me. We had one from Barcelona. We played for them, of course, in the last My Player series. So I decided that, I don't really want to go back there again. And we had one from Spurs. Now, everything, as an Arsenal fan, told me that I shouldn't go to Spurs. But the reason I chose Chelsea was because in season one, we won the Europa League with Arsenal, but I didn't play a massive part. I think I only played like a few group stage matches and maybe one or two of the knockout rounds. But I didn't play in the final, didn't really play all that much. So you might remember I was saying this towards the back end of my time with Dortmund. You know, it would be cool to win a Europa League as well as the Champions League that I actually feel like I had an impact on. And the chances was that, you know, with Dortmund, we probably weren't going to be in the Europa League. So I checked out this Chelsea team. No clue how, but they are actually in the Europa League this season. Even with the stacked squad that Chelsea have, they are still playing Europa League football and arguably are the favourites to win the entire thing. So it just made sense. Not only that, but we still have to win the Premier League. Our time in the Premier League itself hasn't really been as we were hoping it would be. Let's just say that. And all in all, I have a real optimism about this team, about this Chelsea side that we potentially might not only be able to win the Europa League, but even more as well. Now, one issue I've got with this is that as soon as I joined the club, Chelsea started selling players. And even with the squad depth they have, they've got a lot of good quality players in each position. Timo Werner straight away left the club. So already one of the big players gone out of this Chelsea side. He's gone to Barcelona for like £110 million. And I was kind of thinking we need to make sure that we don't sell too many players because I didn't want a case of me joining the team straight away, them then letting go of their big, you know, stars. So the likes of Havertz, we've got to keep hold of. Serge Gnabry as well, who starts here. And you might even look at that bench and wonder what on earth is going on. Mason Mount on the bench, Pulisic on the bench for this first game against Southampton. My first game back in the Premier League. Yeah, there's a real, real quality in this Chelsea side. And it's still in fact as well, Frank Lampard in charge. For anybody wondering, this series was started before the update. So everything that was at the start of, you know, the year is how it all pans out, right? So Lampard's in charge at Chelsea. I think Emery might even be in charge at Arsenal. So, oh no, it's Arteta, sorry. Yeah, it's definitely Arteta. I won't mind about Emery in charge of Arsenal. He came last year, Arteta. But there's one or two other managers anyway that I know aren't currently in charge who will be in the series because of that fact, right? So that's kind of just to tell you that bit. But hopefully you're excited for our journey with Chelsea. A few of you may have predicted that we were joining Chelsea when I said that it would be an English club back in the Premier League. So well done to you, those of you who did. But I knew I wanted to play the first few games. We had Southampton and then Villa. And I thought to myself, don't really need to play either one of these. We're expected to win both. To be fair, though, Southampton put up a good fight and arguably could have got something out of the game as in the last minute of it, Kepa was called into action to deny Sims an equaliser. So, yeah, we got a win, 1-0, we assisted the goal, but it wasn't really a great game to start things off with, so I was hoping for much more against Villa. But to talk about as well, a new signing, Moyes Keane has joined the club as our new striker. We needed to go out and get one, especially with Timo Werner leaving. We played with Piontek up front in the last match. He scored the goal, but I didn't really feel like he had that much of a good game for us. So I knew just off the balance of that, we had to go out and get a striker. And luckily, Frank also realised that. Brought in Moyes Keane. He started against Villa and we hit the ball rolling in terms of our goals after the 48th minute. Here at Stamford Bridge, in front of the home fans, we gave our side, our new side, the lead and went over to celebrate as well. It seems so strange. I'm just so used to us being in a yellow kit that now we're in the blue. It looks weird, but at the same time, I guess we'll have to get used to it, right? We're here for at least this season, and I'd say probably one more as well straight after. So the aim for us this year, I think, has got to be, as this goal was probably my favourite, we play the ball out to Chilwell. He whips the cross in, get our head there as well. We scored two from this one. But the aim for this season has got to be A, winning the Europa League, B, trying to get back into the Champions League through the league itself, so top four positions, And then seeing if we can add a cheeky cup on there, maybe an FA Cup in there as well. That's probably the aim for us, right? Because when we look at this side and look at the ability that it's got, you've got to say Chelsea could win everything. But I don't want to get too ahead of myself. There are some really good teams in the Premier League. City are the current Premier League holders and Champions League holders. United have got a good squad. Liverpool, as always, are competitive. Let's not worry about Arsenal. Let's not even talk about them. Spurs look pretty well, pretty good as well. So, yeah, I'm not even going to mention Arsenal because they are absolutely a joke, to put it plain and simply. You'll see later on where they are after five league matches, and it's just not good at all. But as Chelsea were running rampant here at Stamford Bridge to go 3-0 in front, we've actually got Spurs straight after this, and it was the last of the post-com matches. We've got six games to show you today, three live, three post-com. So I'm saying this right now, sit back, relax and enjoy. A bit later on in the video than I probably should have. But yeah, I do hope you enjoy the matches. And I'm hoping to get you guys another episode of this series out very soon. Now that we have a new club, start getting the episodes thick and fast. Help us get through the season a bit quicker. You do play four matches more, of course, in the Premier League than you do in the Bundesliga. So that's essentially like a whole other episode as well on top of our normal matches. But 3-1 win, two wins from two so far on our return to England. Feels a lot different than when we were last here with the Arsenal team, let me just tell you that. Less frustrating for one. Another sale though. Ben Chilwell this time's gone. He's left the club and gone to Real Madrid. And then another as Jules Koundé, hopefully I've said his name right, has left to go to Barcelona. So two more sales for Chelsea. And also a massive, massive transfer fee for Boubacar Kamara to Spurs, who starts and makes his debut against us here from Leicester. What a payout it is for Leicester as well. I mean, don't get me wrong, he's a good player, but is he 100 and odd million pound good? I'm not so sure. That's the Spurs side that we might have joined. Decided against it, of course, to come here to Chelsea instead. I've got no idea if Spurs are in the Europa League or Champions League. I should have probably checked that. But the game itself, inside half an hour, we really should have been leading. Look how close this was from Kai Havertz to give us the lead. And as you see it from the replay right now, this is where you realise just how close it was. I mean, inches to the right and it's Chelsea 1, Spurs 0. Spurs, though, should have been really in front themselves as well. Harry Kane turning provider, sending Lo Celso through. He rounds Kepa, and I don't know how, he sort of miskicks the ball, and it should have really been Spurs 1-0 up. And it actually was Lo Celso getting all of Spurs' chances, as in the second half he tested Kepa. But all in all, a 0-0 draw is how it finished. Quite anticlimactic, to be honest. And that means that we now face City. And they are the current Premier League holders and Champions League holders, I believe, winning both of those trophies last season. But if there's ever a time to play them, you'd want it to be the start of the year before they can build up any momentum. And right now, they've drawn two of their first three against West Ham and Liverpool in a 0-0 and a 1-1 draw, respectively, and then beaten Stoke by 2-1. So our record so far better than theirs. But I do know for City, at the moment, they've only got one recognisable left-back at the team, which might be the reason that Phil Foden is starting at left back. I have absolutely no idea what is going on there. I checked their team because I saw that Foden was playing left back. And when I looked, they've got one left back who is a game-generated player. So I'm not sure on his overall or anything like that. Just EA things, just FIFA things, I guess. But for us, I believe we are unchanged from the side that played against Spurs. So we'll see if that's going to result in a win instead of a 0-0 draw. And yeah, still can't get over the fact that Foden is playing left back for Man City. I have noticed on our return to English football that it's been a bit harder for me to kind of, I guess, control games, if you will. We are playing in our more natural left midfield role now rather than the centre mid role we were playing at Dortmund. But it just feels like, although we seem to be able to have just as much impact, it's a little bit harder to create the chances. And I don't know if that's because of the fact that we're playing out wide now or if it's just teams in the Premier League generally are harder to break down defensively. Speaking of which, City looking for a chance, cut out well. And I forgot to mention as well, I've not used the competitor mode for this match, so let me know if you want us to use that, as we've got Kai Havertz through the middle. Havertz to make it 1-0. He's never going to pass up an opportunity like that. And after 12 minutes, I said this might be the best time to play Manchester City when they are yet to build any momentum. No idea what the celebration from Kai Havertz is. But you can see the Chelsea fans, they are absolutely loving this. And so they should. Kai Havertz straight through the middle, City all over the place defensively. They had an early warning sign with Havertz. First shot blocked early on, but did not heed it. And he's made it 1-0 Chelsea. That's a great ball over the top from Saul, which Bernardo Silva gives chase to. Jimenez does well as he's found the feet of Atal, played back for Romagnoli. Just trying to calm the play down right now, Chelsea, and are very confident to play their way out of defence with the ball back to Kepa, who loses possession. Now Raheem Sterling. In comes the challenge of Jimenez, and Havertz plays as, and now then, you can see as we've got Moyes Keane over on the left-hand side. Chelsea looking for a breakaway chance to make it 2-0. Moyes Keane needs to do the right option, and he goes alone. And Moyes Keane doubles Chelsea's advantage at Stamford Bridge with a fine finish into the bottom right corner, and City are crumbling. If this is the City side that won the league and the Champions League last year, I've no idea how. They've got to have lost some players. And look at the Chelsea fans, they're going mental in the stands. They've got to have lost some players, Manchester City, because I just don't understand it. Why have they only got one left back, and why is Phil Foden playing there? And surprisingly, he's not even the reason they're 2-0 down. Pep, you can look on and be frustrated, but I don't know what you're thinking with your team selection. Kante with the ball down the left-hand side. Chelsea with options in the middle. Runners arriving. There's the ball to the back post, looking for Serge Gnabry. And Chelsea make it 3. Serge Gnabry at the back post with a fine volley past Zach Steffen. And with half an hour to play, it's getting worse for the holders of the Premier League. And judging by the two matches we've played today against two challenging fixtures, we've got more to worry about, about Spurs than we do City looking at this. When you look at the Chelsea substitutions that we have made, Christian Pulisic on for Serge Gnabry and Mason Mount on for Kai Havertz. Not bad changes to be able to make off the bench, are they? Very, very good squad depth here at Chelsea. And we go in search of goal number 4, lifting it, poor ball in the end from me, towards that back post. And Atal is unable to keep it in play. And that's on me, really. That was not my finest cross. And the final change of the match comes through for us. Moyes Keane off, and on comes Mutianu. Hopefully I've said his name right. Moyes Keane had a good game here. Got himself on the score sheet for that second goal, of course. There's even time as well here for us to try and find a fourth. City just committing so many bodies up the field of play. Leaves them exposed at the back, near post. And Steffen makes the save, but the ball falls back for Pulisic. He'll gladly accept that. It's Chelsea 4, City 0. What are we witnessing here? I don't know, to be honest. I really have no idea. And as this ball comes through, you can see Steffen initially does well to make the save. But then the ball falls just in the path of Pulisic, who has a tap-in. 4 minutes added on here at Stamford Bridge, but it's not enough time for a City fight back. And Kante can take us forward. Now Pulisic, he's got runners in front of him, but he wants to go himself, Christian Pulisic. And he's got a great turn of pace to be able to break down the right-hand side. And referee, why have you blown the whistle there? We had a chance to make it 5, but nevertheless, get a load of this. It's Chelsea 4, Manchester City 0. News to tell you about in the outgoings. Billy Gilmore has left the club to join Villa for £38 million. And also Rafinha has left Spurs to go to PSG. So that's two big sales from the Premier League. Gilmore is still in the Premier League, as Villa are in the league that we are in. Nearly said Premier League like 3 times there. But anyways, to let you know, City have lost Kevin De Bruyne in this window. And I know that he's a massive miss, but that doesn't explain their horrific performance there. Well, they do still have Ederson. He has played 3 of the 4 Premier League matches. So I don't know why Steffen played that one, whether or not Ederson had a small injury or whatever. Gabriel Jesus, who started in 3 of the 4, did not start. Masias started in that game. Bernardo Silva, Raheem Sterling as well. Valverde, Saul all started against us. Phil Foden as well, but he started at left back. As I mentioned, in regards to their left back situation, they haven't even played a left back once. Delano Malin is the only man who can play left back for Manchester City, and he's not started a game yet. So that tells me that they've actually been probably playing either Phil Foden there or Dest maybe. But all in all, that's not really what you want to see. I've just realised as well, they didn't start Tapsoba. You might remember how good he was for Dortmund. So I think looking at the teams around the Premier League, the most favourite, you could say, aside from us, would be probably Liverpool. But United, they've had a great window. They've not sold anyone. At least I don't think so. and have brought in a couple of real stars. So Henderson is their goalkeeper, top goalkeeper, of course. Martial still there, 5-4 so far. Rashford still there, Sigankov. Dele Alli's there as well, Julian Brandt. So United are probably the Manchester club to look out for in this season, it has to be said. There was a couple of England matches, which I opted not to play in. It was a couple of qualifying games, and we'd already qualified. So, yeah, I think we finished top. I will double-check that. And we've got two matches to come then, as we face Wolves away at Molineux, and we've been given a very favourable Europa League group. I said that it was one of the reasons why I chose to join Chelsea, the Europa League. We did win it with Arsenal in Season 1, but I didn't play in any of the knockout rounds, really, or the final. So I decided that it doesn't really count, although we played a couple of group stage matches. There's our group. And as I say, it's favourable. We should top it with ease. As for the World Cup qualifiers with England, there's confirmation that we finished top of the group as well on 25 points. So job done there. Off to Molineux we go. And let's not get ahead of ourselves, even though we're joint top off the back of a 4-0 win against Man City. They didn't really perform. And we'll see if Wolves can do any better. Let's have a look at their team. There you go. They've got Rui Patricio still in goal. Golovin and Gibbs-White as a midfield too. Skov Olsen up at right wing, Semedo at right back, so their usual five at the back formation. Whereas for Chelsea, there's a debut for the new man, João Cancelo, who's in ahead of Atal. Nabry with the Chelsea corner, goes deep towards Havertz, and Chelsea lead 17 minutes into the game. Kai Havertz rises highest from the Serge Nabry corner and heads us into the lead here. And you've got to say, from Wolves' perspective, the amount of players they've got in that penalty area, Havertz wins it too easily. Here is Havertz off to Bakayoko. Chelsea gaining confidence with Moyes Keane now in possession. Bakayoko inside the area. Brilliant feat. And he deserved a goal at the end of it. But Rui Patricio makes the save. And it'll be another Chelsea corner. Chelsea free kick. Serge Gnabry goes into the box. Havertz gets there again. Oh my goodness. What a header. Usually from those type of free kicks, you see absolutely nothing. But that from Kai Havertz is sensational. I don't know how on earth he's turned this into the back of the net. He's off balance and everything. We have to see this. Gnabry just lifts the ball in. And once again, Havertz has three Wolves players around him. I'm stunned. Absolutely stunned. What a header. Chelsea lead by two, and it's two set pieces that have undone Wolves. Pretty much been a spectator for most of this first half, but as Kai Havertz lays that ball towards us, Moyes Keane waits in the middle. Chelsea have their third, and this game is all but done in the first half. I've had not much to do at all. It's been the rest of my teammates just completely outplaying Wolves. Havertz again involved, this time plays the easy ball to our feet, and if I'd have not squared that to Moyes Keane, there'd have been questions asked. And there he is with the finish. He's had a good first half as well, Moyes Keane. And Chelsea have deserved their lead. Oh, mistake by Wolves. We charge down. And now Keane looking for a shooting chance. Lays the ball towards us. And Moyes Keane returns the favour from the first half. We set him up. And now he returns the favour our way. It's Chelsea 4, Wolves 0. And Wolves have been the makers of their own problems today. You can see that it's been two set pieces. And then that one there. I mean, we make a mistake trying to play a pass through. But then they just dilly-dally on the ball. Delay it. We charge them down. Win it back. And it's not in the corner. But Patricio, we're too close to him for him to really react. Good run down the left from Luka Digne. And here he is on the ball then. Early cross into the middle. Away by Urai. Chelsea trying to keep the pressure on and go for goal number five. And they look to do it now with Cancelo blocking the header away, and Wolves can't quite get this ball away just yet. Here is Kante. Off to Luka Digne again. We are in acres of space in the middle. Digne's pass! And it's in the top corner. Chelsea have a fifth. And aside from Havertz's header, his second one, this is probably the pick of the goals, you could say. So rocket into the top right corner. I looked at that City result and thought, there's no way we get it again. Well, in fact, we've bettered it here at Molineux. And now I'm starting to think we probably do need the competitor mode activated. I knew this Chelsea side looked good on paper, but it's performing as well. Look at that for a finish. Semedo, that is a great first touch from him, and he works his way into the penalty area. Nelson Semedo nearly scores a wonder goal, a solo wonder goal, but it's finished here at Molineux with a late piece of top quality ability from Semedo. 5-0 Chelsea. We had a quiet first half, but with a 10 match rating, and Semedo nearly scores the goal of the game at the end there. That deserved the finish. Away trip to the Netherlands for us then, and we are completely unchanged. The same starting 11 that just demolished Wolves by 5-0 starts here tonight, and you're expecting probably the same result, in fairness. If not, maybe better. But I guess we'll see. It's our first Europa League match in quite a few years, and I really want to make an impact. You've got to say, got to win this. We have to win the Europa League. With the strength of this Chelsea side, I don't know how they're in the Europa League, though. 17 minutes in and Chelsea haven't scored yet. What's going on? Let's change that right here. Havertz off to Bakayoko. Still giving support, Kai Havertz. Finds us now with that pass. And look at his run straight through here. There's the ball towards him. Havertz saved. And it's a very good save at that as well from the Willem II goalkeeper. And that was the first chance that Chelsea have been able to craft then. And to be fair, Willem II dealt with it. 10 minutes left of this first half and the scoreline's still 0-0. And we've not dominated this first half at all. So this is not panning out as I expected. Owusu over on the left-hand side, surrounded by Chelsea players, but still has possession. The ball over the top then. Kepa needs to come out and claim this. He opts to punch it, though, rather than catch. And that's going to keep the pressure on Chelsea. And for now, we are not only not leading at half-time, we need to make sure we don't go in 1-0 down. As they're building an attack here. Morosini turning away, ball into the middle. And they're still with possession. They're very calm on it as well, to be fair. I mean, they're in the Europa League, Willem II. We don't want to disrespect them. They've got here, and they deserve our respect. But just judging by the way we were playing, I thought we'd pretty much be already 1-0 up at this stage. And we have got some pace here, as you can see, to be able to try and get inside their penalty area. Keane waits in the middle. Moise Keane! It's another big save, but it's a poor finish, you've got to say, by Chelsea's striker. Moise Keane looked favourite to score there. And he hits it straight at the goalkeeper. Bakayoko then. A minute added on by the referee. Kante now. Ball through to us. Are we going to get one last attack before the end of the first half? The right footed cross into the middle. Away it goes. And Willem II are 0-0 after 45 minutes. And I'm sort of just popping up in a more central area. How about that for a pass through? Oh, what a goal that is. Moise Keane finishes it off. And after all their hard work, the home side have been broken. I mean, the pass, you know what? I'm trying to decide whether or not it was a great through ball or if we just got lucky. Because as I play this ball through, I mean, there's not a massive amount of pace on the pass. And I'm wondering if the defender should have been favourite to get there. We're not going to complain, though, because Moise Keane latches onto it. And first time finds the bottom corner. Classy finish from a classy player, and Chelsea have their breakthrough. Kante with the ball through, Piontek, and he's in. Is the offside flag going to go up? Yes, it does. Been on the pitch for a matter of a few minutes, Piontek. He replaced the potential match winner, Mr. Moise Keane, of course. And as you see, oh my. I'd love to see that one again, because that is incredibly close. Into injury time we go, and it'll be a good win for Chelsea, even though it looks like a very close match. 1-0 the score, but of course, their goalkeeper has made a couple of really good saves, so they've him to thank, the home side, and ultimately we got the job done. It wasn't as one-sided as we thought, in fairness though. So yeah, it was good to get the win. Moise Keane with the only goal from the match, a well-taken finish in the 73rd minute, but the win is what we came for, and that is what we've got. And that, my friends, is how we will end today's episode. We've played 6 matches, winning 5 of the 6, drawing that one against Spurs, and we find ourselves top of the Premier League, 2 points clear of Liverpool and Newcastle. Commentators cursed, though, because Manchester United have slipped up with a 2-1 defeat to Southampton, who find themselves into 8th. As for the bottom half of the table, our former club Norwich down in 13th, but take a look at this, Arsenal 17th, a point above the relegation zone. Unbelievable. I don't know what on earth is going on there. And yeah, they better not go down, I'll just say that for sure. Just the one game played so far in the Europa League, but this is how the table looks. And as you see, we are top after Craiova managed a draw against Nice. So fair play to them. I didn't expect that. And Nice have drawn their opening match and we play them next time. So we'll keep our eyes on that. The only hope for us to maybe get Dortmund would be if they end up getting knocked out in third out of their Champions League group, which looks like this. So I doubt that's going to happen with Shakhtar Donetsk, Milan and CSKA Moscow. You'd expect Dortmund to advance through in the Champions League. So we'll keep our eyes on that as well. A massive thank you for watching today's episode. If you did enjoy it, a like would be greatly appreciated. As always, a huge thank you for all of your support on the channel as well. If you are new around here and like what you see, hit that subscribe button down below. Until next time, stay safe. Have a great day. Have a great evening. Much love, people. And I'll catch you all again soon. Adios.